Raheem, thanks for being with us. What does that mean to you as a guy who plays the position, knowing you're on a list that includes the greatest postseason performance of all time? It's Eric Dickerson and you.
Hey, good morning, you guys. And, man, you know, it's unbelievable. It's so surreal. I never thought I'd be, you know, first off, speaking to you guys about this, you know, this topic. It's one of those things where I, like I said, it's so surreal, and I truly can't believe it. I'm honestly blessed.
And it's amazing the story as well. Played your years at Purdue, and then your time in the NFL, and the story been talked about more and more. You've been cut seven times, and now you're doing this on the field. And it's just such a great story for perseverance and keep going through adversity. Was there a point through the times that you were getting cut where you almost said, okay, I'm not making it here. I'm ready to move on from football?
Yeah, it was after my rookie year. I was with Cleveland. And, yeah, it was one of those things. I don't know if you guys have heard, but I made the roster after the preseason. First off, let's go back a little bit. I skipped the last preseason game due to a hamstring injury, and you know, I made the roster. Thought I was in good standings with the team, and went out and celebrated with my family. Then the next day, I got cut. You know, they had to move on. And it was one of those things where, hey, look, you know, I had to talk with my wife. She's actually from Cleveland. So it all worked out. I was right there, you know. I had a family with me through the dark time. And, you know, I had to talk with her and her parents and, you know, just ask them, hey, what do you see, you know, myself moving forward? Like, what do you think is going to happen now? And they said, hey, look, truthfully, if you love the game of football like we know you do, you've been playing it since you were 7 years old, you know that you'll do anything for it, and you know, you'll keep pushing, you'll find a way. And I sat down, and you know, like I said, it was one of those things where I had a so surreal moment, you know, making a decision whether I wanted to keep going through, you know, cuts and the adversity and, you know, being the biggest underdog and all that type of stuff. And yeah, I sat down and I made a decision. I said, hey, you know what? I love this game. I have people in my corner, and let's keep pressing on. Let's keep fighting on, and let's get this thing done.
Talking to Raheem Mostert, 49ers running back, an incredible story there. Through all that now, you go through that, you make that decision. Was there a time where you could finally exhale and say, all right, I feel like I belong in this league now. I feel secure in my place here.
No, that's one thing about the league. You're never secure. Even you know, some of the guys, you know, I talked to throughout my time, they told me, hey, this job is never secure. The only thing that's secure, more so, is the ownership and the GM at times. You know, they'll have a little bit longer of a stint with the organization. I knew right then and there that, hey, no matter what, you know, the punches that are getting thrown at me, I'm going to do what I got to do to try to stay on the team, whether that's to be this, you know, the best guy on special teams or potentially, you know, becoming a running back. That's always been my mindset. And, I just had to stick with that philosophy.
Raheem Mostert with us, Niners running back, and you're on a really good team to be a running back because you guys run the ball, I don't know, a lot. I'm just curious, at one point during the NFC Championship game, because you ran it 42 times, Jimmy threw it 8 times, did you say to yourself, are we throwing the ball? Have we thrown a pass today? At what point did you, as an active player, think, wait a minute, are we not doing that?
Yeah, actually, truthfully, I'm going to tell you what happened. So, I'm sitting down, you know, just got done with the drive. It's like the end of the third quarter going into the fourth quarter. And I look up at the scoreboard and, you know, they display the stats per team, like rushing and passing. And, you know, I look at it, and I'm like, man, 200 yards rushing. Like we're really running the ball, like only 40 yards passing. And Jimmy comes up to me and he's like, hey, Heem, what, how many yards you got? I'm like, man, dude, I don't even know. I know we're running the ball a lot. And I'm like, hey, look, I think I got, like, after looking at the board, I'm like, hey, man, I think I got, like, 200 rushing yards. He's like, oh, no way, really? I'm like, yeah. And he's like, how many passing yards do we have? He hasn't looked up at, mind you, at this time, he hasn't looked up at the scoreboard to see the stats. I'm like, Jimmy, look up. I pointed at the scoreboard, and he's like, dude, I've only thrown the ball for 55 yards. Like, he could not believe it. He's like, well, I mean, and then he tells me, he's like, well, I mean, hey, you know, I'm 8 for 8 on completions for the day. I'm like, hey, yeah, your completion rate's very well right now.
But yeah, wow.
It was just at that moment, I knew, I was like, man, we're really attacking them in the run game. And, you know, what better way to close out a game than to have the ball in that situation, you know, 4 minutes left and you're in a 4 minute offense and you got to stay in bounds, you know, couple first downs, secure the game. And, yeah, a lot of stuff was taken over at that time. And, yeah, we were just running the ball well and efficient. So if Jimmy was happy, you know, that's good. Literally, he was in the huddle and he was just warming up his arm, you know, doing arm circles and stuff like that. And I'm like, Jimmy, you know it's going to be a run. Like, yeah, come on.
But it's so interesting. Like, you're part of a backfield between you and Matt Breida and certainly Tevin Coleman.
Yeah.
There doesn't seem to be a lot of ego on this team in general. You see everyone doing a lot of that work. What is that conversation like? Because this whole playoff run has been largely without Jimmy having to throw the ball a ton. What's that been like for him as a guy who I'm sure wants to be involved and wants to do his part like that?
Yeah, you know, first in our room, man, the running backs, man, there's no egos. All egos are all set to the side. You know, our standard is, hey, look, we're trying to get to the dance, which we did. Now we're trying to win the dance. You know, we're trying to win the big game. And we know each guy has a critical role on the team, and you know, we have to back each other up. And that's the one thing I could truthfully say. Out of all my years I've played ball, man, this group of running backs, this is the closest I've ever been to a group of guys.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.